Hi everyone, I'm Anais and right now I'm in Berlin, Germany working on a really exciting project with Curious Minds and I've got a question for you. What does curiosity mean to you? Anyway, as you may be able to guess just from the title of my channel, curiosity is something that's very, very important to me. I want people to feel things when they watch my videos, and generally what I want them to feel is the joy of learning something new, maybe that eureka moment when you put two and two together of something you didn't know before, or a sense of curiosity where you just want to go and discover lots of new things. Now, Merck recently conducted a study with scientists and innovators where they asked them whether they thought curiosity was essential or not in making new discoveries, and 80% of them thought that it was, but only 20% of them self-identified as curious, and obviously that's a worrying discrepancy. However, I personally don't think curiosity is something that you are or you want. I think it's a little bit like a muscle where you can train it, you can make yourself more curious or have a more curious mindset. So that is what we're exploring today. There are four dimensions to curiosity: creativity and problem solving, distress tolerance, openness to other ideas, and inquisitiveness, which I explored across four videos with several talented scientists and innovators. I explored the first one with Simon Clark, whom you may know already.
The worst case scenario happened and it wasn't that bad.
Exactly.
We talked about creativity, which is one of my favourite topics personally, and one of the things we did was to attempt to come up with a solution to a lateral thinking riddle.
Picture the scene, Romeo and Juliet, they're both dead. There is water, there is broken glass, and the window is open, but not broken. What's happened?
As well as talk about how he incorporates creativity into his PhD work and his YouTube channel. The second dimension is distress tolerance, which I explored with Samuel Gunya. Interestingly, the production of this video also involved overcoming distress tolerance. Samuel's first language isn't English, and he personally preferred to give his answers in Brazilian Portuguese.
Isso me motiva a tentar ser mais alegre, mais divertido, mais espontâneo.
So in order to get an actual answer, I spoke with him in Spanish in between takes, and there was also an interpreter on set to make sure that he was able to communicate easily with everyone who couldn't understand Portuguese. The third dimension of curiosity is openness to new ideas, in essence, being able to view things from different perspectives. I explored this with Ava Amson and Shigang He. There's actually a technique known as the six thinking hats, which can help you to view situations from at least six different perspectives. For myself, I'm usually an optimistic person, so I do try to force myself to see things from different perspectives as well. And last but not least, the fourth dimension is inquisitiveness, whose importance I explored with Jacob Futuriansky. We're not always looking for answers, but also for questions. We talked about Jacob's approach to questioning, and we asked a lot of questions.
Can clouds be moody?
Can bugs be philosophical?
Can cars be invisible?
Can hair be farmed?
Can trees be mindful?
Can bees be inventors?
Can technology be caring?
Can brains be connected?
Can food be downloaded?
Can brushes be heard?
Can apples be catalysts?
Can bricks be brainy?
Can wasps be artists?
Can water be clothing?
Can plants be entertainers?
Whoa, that was a lot of questions.
Anyway, I really, really hope you enjoyed this quick introduction. If you're curious about this project, you can follow the links in the description below to see Merck's interactive programme. There's a curiosity test which you can take, a report and study you can read, the four videos we made that you can watch, and some activities for you to play around with and train your curiosity today. Thank you so much to Merck for letting me be a part of such a fun campaign. And as always, thank you so much for watching me, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.